since I work from 6 a.m. to 3 p.m. in the day, normally as a group on our team at work, we take our first break around 8 a.m. And then around lunchtime, we break from 11 to 12 for lunch, and then the final break is 1:45 to 2. Now, those designated breaks are, we all take them together. But just personally, somebody who suffers from immense and strong panic attacks, and somebody that kind of doesn't know exactly when those panic attacks can arise, and, you know, I really don't have any control over that, I want to know, is it absolutely certain that I have to take the breaks when other employees or my fellow coworkers are taking their breaks as well?
That's a great question. Wow, thanks so much, Tim. So what?
Well, here's what I understood you to say, is you're getting two breaks, or you're getting two breaks and then you're getting a lunch break. What your question is, well, I can't really tell when I may have a medical issue. If that's the case, then that's something you need to discuss with your employer, and maybe they can make an accommodation for you. But again, because you're working in a team environment, it could be that the breaks have to be taken when the employer schedules them.
I agree with you, Tim. And Tim, thank you for your question. That's a very challenging circumstance that you find yourself in. And I agree with Tim. I think probably, and I would need to do more research on this, and you're welcome to call me, or I'm sure call Tim, and we could look at this a little more when we have a little more time, because I've never encountered that particular issue. I think the law is satisfied that the employer is offering you the breaks, and if it needs to be at a time when everyone is stopping, it's probably the employer is probably technically in compliance. My question for you, though, is going to be whether you might have some protection under a different statute, and that's the Americans with Disabilities Act. If you can do your work, but you can do so with a reasonable accommodation, and perhaps a reasonable accommodation for you would be being able to be a bit more flexible with the breaks. It's very fact specific. It depends on the work, it depends on the employer, it depends on your job title and job description, but and also it depends on the number of employees. Not every employer is required to accommodate workers. You have to have an employer that's large enough, and under the statute, the Americans with Disabilities Act, you have to have at least 15 employees. So not knowing where you work, whether that's even feasible, it's something for you to look into, though. And there's a great website the federal government maintains on the Americans with Disabilities Act. Take a look at it and see if that's something that you might want to use, as Tim said, to go and talk to your employer and just get a little bit of education for both yourself and your employer. It might be something that you can satisfy rather easily with just a little education and a conversation.